La biodiversité est-elle un état ou une
biodiversity,
dynamique?
Is it a state
discuter,
or a dynamic?
Regardons le diagramme que Darwin publie dans l'origine des espèces en 1859.
Let us look at Darwin's diagram 1859, the origin of species. He explains his theory.
Time is a bottom-up process,
as is always the case in phylogeny's diversification of living beings. But let us not be cheated by appearances. We shouldn't believe that a drawing because it looks like another one means exactly the same thing. What I showed you is not a phylogeny.
En réalité, l'arbre de Darwin
actually,
a
Darwin's
non seulement une direction verticale, donc qui donne
has
le temps
a vertical direction, time, bottom
mais
up,
aussi une dimension
this
horizontale
is a geologist's habit,
une mesure
but also a horizontal dimension showing ecological differentiation in the lineages. The further apart the lineages are on the horizontal axis, the more different they are ecologically speaking. So what happens here is not the same as what happens in a conventional phylogeny such as this, where various forms of living beings are placed arbitrarily based on their history and not based on their ecology. In Darwin's drawing, every lineage at every time produces new forms, and most of the new forms become extinct. But some will remain, especially the ones that are further apart, because by being further apart, competition is reduced. Further apart in the ecological meaning, different niches, different habitats, and this is why the forms will be preserved. Now, this repeated phenomenon, generation after generation, over time, allows the various lineages to diverge and to produce other forms, even more differentiated forms, which means that biodiversity is something that happens in a constant way and is also destroyed continuously through extinction processes. We'll come back to that. The way we describe diversity thanks to systematics in species, grouped in genera,
classes, this
way of classifying biodiversity attempts to translate with limited elements a continuous differentiation process. Obviously, this is an arbitrary process, and Darwin insists by saying that until now we've not been able to trace the demarcation between species and subspecies, neither have we found a demonstration between subspecies and varieties or sensitive varieties and individual differences. So the difference between species, subspecies, varieties, and individuals, there is a continuum, and the differences emerge with insensitive degrees to become a real series. So Darwin lays the emphasis on the fact that we've never been able to provide a clear definition as to when two lineages become a species is normal, because it's a progressive process. But he will come up against the fact that biology thinks in terms of species, classes, which are tight versus each other. Following the publication of The Origin of Species, 1861, year after 1859, he wrote to a friend, "I am often in despair, making the generality of naturalists even comprehend me. Intelligent men who are not naturalists have not a bigoted idea of the term species show more clearness of mind." There is like a religious vision of species in biology which obscures our sight regarding the way biodiversity really functions. Now, if we look at biodiversity as it is presented generally, if you go on the web, for instance, you see every time that species come first, as if species were a sort of magical entity, an entity created unto itself, for itself, and independently from the others, and not a progressive differentiation in a tree. And yet we find it difficult to define species. Many books have been written, and whichever criteria we use, we find things that don't work in plants, species, cross. So forget about plants, forget about bacteria, animals. We thought it would work and there would be a difference between species, but we know that zebras and monkeys and horses can mate, that some mules will be survived, but not all of them. And we had the same surprise with lion, tigers, and leopards. The first time we saw a hybrid between a lion and a tiger, it came as a surprise. And the religious idea of species appeared at that time because all of a sudden people said, "Oh, the hybrids are going to be sterile." We had no idea that they would be sterile, but they had to be sterile. Otherwise, this would question the whole concept of species. Unluckily, some of them were fertile, but never mind. Species are not a tight entity. Species is only a branch from the tree that differentiated itself sufficiently to become a species and have a statute unto itself. And if we don't understand that, we make mistakes. For instance, here we have a pie chart with six or seven times more species of insects and plants. than plants, but many people think that there is more diversity in insects than in plants. People say half diversity is in insects. No, this is not true. Insects make very small, very subtle species. The pie is divided in very small slices with very specific species. Very homogeneous ones, and there are twin species that are different, but they look like each other. So in plants, there is a lot of diversity. Plants make big slices, insects make small slices. And if you count the number of slices, you don't really count the number of animals or bugs. As if people use the idea of evolution to replace the idea of creation. The idea would be that evolution created all species, and in the end came man, whereas we were not the very last to appear. The last species that appeared was the mosquito in the London Underground. So evolution did not create species. Evolution is a permanent process, producing new different things, differentiation, divergence between lineages, and extinction processes. Let us not forget that in this pattern, we have extinction. The extinction is not the limit of biodiversity. If there was no extinction, there would be no biodiversity, because extinction creates the void between two lineages. If there were no extinction, there would be a continuum, and there would be far less biodiversity than what we have. So we may say that extinction sculpts biodiversity as cellular death sculpts our fingers. Extinction sculpts biodiversity, and it does so thanks to the fact that it's compensated for by divergence. Divergence, extinction are the two main elements of the dynamic of biodiversity. So there is balance in biodiversity, equilibrium, but not a static equilibrium. When we're talking about balance, we think about a stable balance or an unstable balance, but a static balance. If it's unstable, it's still static, but dynamic balance is not so well understood. A bicycle only can go forward because it can hold because it moves, and because it moves forward, we can compensate for the movements that would make it fall right or left. We can calculate the forces going in this or that direction, and if we stop the bicycle, then this is the result, a catastrophic fall. Same for an airplane. An airplane has a dynamic balance between gravity that brings it down and the force on the wings that brings it up. A satellite, exactly the same, or a planet, for that matter. They all find themselves in a dynamic equilibrium, and if they slow down, they fall down. We have an intuitive perception of this dynamic equilibrium in our body. We have a dynamic balance with our environment. We eat, we create, we breathe, and this is what keeps our body in the dynamic. We have such a dynamic perception, intuitive perception, that if somebody said to you, I like you, I want to keep you, I'll put you in a fridge, you wouldn't agree, because we know that by losing dynamic equilibrium, and we lose life. So if we want to think about biodiversity, we need to think about it as a dynamic status and not a stable status. It cannot be kept as such. It cannot be maintained or preserved in a fridge. That would be a huge mistake. Biodiversity must continue to move forward. We must encourage movement. And if we don't encourage forward motion, biodiversity and ourselves will fall down. And that will be a dangerous fall. So I wish that at the end of my presentation, people will understand that the Darwinian pattern represents biodiversity. If we want to understand biodiversity, we should never forget the necessity of a dynamic balance between divergence and extinction. Life's dynamic is so obvious that even physicists, who normally don't understand anything about biology, understood this. And Albert Einstein said, life is like a bicycle. You have to move forward or else you lose your balance.